Ash and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a makeup review on this brand right here. This is the Belle Hyperallergenic Makeup, and this brand is catered towards sensitive skin. So if you're worried about putting on makeup and it gives you irritation, breakout, sensitivity to your skin, then you might be really really interested in this brand right here. So for me, I do have like sensitive dry skin, and I've been testing this product out for about 1 month or more, and I really can say that these definitely didn't give me any irritation or breaks out on my skin. So I picked out around 10 products to create like this very simple look right here without like including any of the eye makeup. So if you're interested in wanting to know more about this brand and more about the product, then just keep watching. But as always, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already. Also follow me on Instagram and my Facebook page at things-beauty. Like this video if you enjoyed, and comment down below what future videos would you like to see, and just keep watching. So in this video, I've been reviewing all the products plus demo application clips. And before jumping into the video, I just want to let you know that these products are made in the Euro and finally are available in Malaysia at Karen Pharmacies. So I'll be listing all the product names, details, and also the prices down in the description box below. So let's jump into the video. So the first product we're gonna talk about is this right here. This is the Hyperallergenic Matte and Smooth Makeup Base. So essentially, this is a primer before your foundation. It's smoothing and also mattifying. One thing I really like about this primer is because it actually mattifies without leaving the skin super dry. Because a lot of the mattifying primers that I tried before, it really is like sucks out all the moisture of the skin, leaving the skin looking very dry, sometimes can even become cakey. But because of this like formula, it has a, like a lotion type of feeling, and it just smooths the skin very nicely. Even though it didn't really like cover up the pores or fine line, but to act as like a normal primer to just set a barrier onto the skin within the foundation and your skin, I think this is a very good product. So the next product I use after using my foundation is this right here. This is the Hyperallergenic Matte Powder, and it's a mattifying powder. So one thing I really like about this powder right here, again, it doesn't make the skin super dry or cakey looking, even though it's like a mattifying powder, but it is seriously so smooth to the skin. Like, it's so smooth, and as you can see from the demo application clip, even the pattern on the powder is already gone because I've been using this powder so much, and I really just like how smooth and like flawless it gives the skin is without leaving the skin super dry. Moving on to the only eye product that I got, which is mainly for the brows, is this right here. This is the Hyperallergenic Eyebrow Set, and when you open it up, I first of all really need to say of how much I love the packaging of this overall product right here. You get a very beautiful squared mirror, and you get a brow wax and a 2 brow powders, a small spoolie, and also a angle liner brush to just fill in your eyebrows. So I really am surprised of how much I actually like this eyebrow set right here, because if you know me, I really love using like my eyebrow pencil or like eyebrow pomade. But I first of all use the brow wax to just use my finger to just like brush through my brow hairs to really make the eyebrow powder to really adhere to the brows, and I use all of the applicator in this brow set, and it just gives a very like natural yet defined brow look, and it just really is very very nice, and it just gives like a very defined look without making the brows too like thick. And as you can see, the brows is very nice. So I've been really really enjoying this like on the go, especially because of the super cute like packaging. Moving on to more face products right here. One of them are the contour stick, and two of them are the creamy rouge glow sticks right here. So the first stick that I use is the contour stick, and surprisingly enough, it actually gives a very like natural shadow effect. Because of the shade, I thought it's gonna be too light, but it actually surprisingly becomes a very like ashy type of contour that really mimics the shadow. And first of all, I like it a lot because it really blends very nicely onto the skin. Just one thing, that all three of these sticks are actually a little bit on the oilier side, so you might want to like really blend it out nicely and just like touch up here and there, because it can move the base of like your foundation. So that is just a reminder. Next thing is actually the blush one. So I just applied directly onto the skin and using a sponge to just blend it out. And as you can see, I really did need to like build up the intensity on my cheek because I feel it is not too pigmented, but it definitely gives a very beautiful like glowy sheen on the cheek. So if you're the type of person that really likes like glowy cheek without putting like too much highlighter on, definitely look forward to this because it just gives a very like healthy, youthful glow, and as you can see on my skin. First thing that I got right here is to highlight, and I highlighted the top of my cheekbones, the bridge of my nose, Cupid's bow, and also the chin area a little bit, and it gives a very beautiful like bronzy golden effect. The color itself is super beautiful because it's like a bronze champagne. The only thing is, again, it's a little bit on the oilier side, so it might move your like foundation base, but other than that, it's a very beautiful color that doesn't emphasize the texture on your skin, and it blends beautifully onto the skin. Moving on to the next product is this right here. This is the Hypoallergenic Modeling Rouge Blush. So as you can see, the imprint of this is super pretty, and because we use the glow stick blush, isn't really too pigmented, and I just add this on right here and it gives a beautiful like blush to the skin. It's more like a corally pinkish type of color, and it's matte, so it just gives a very nice effect to the skin. It just feels so soft and gentle, and I really like this blush a lot. That's it for the face. Now moving on to some lippies. So I have three lip products right here to show you. So the first one is the Bell Hypoallergenic Lip Tint right here, and I can say to you that this is definitely one of my go-to lip tint because it gives like such a beautiful, comfortable lip tint, and it, because it's like a pinkish strawberry kind of shade, it just glides on so smoothly onto the lips, and this is definitely one of my go-tos. And moving on to the next product right here, this is the Bell Hypoallergenic Lip Liner. As same as this, it glides on so smoothly onto the lips, as you can see from the application, and because of this beautiful like color right here, it's a pinkish nude color, it just lines the lips so perfectly. And because my lips at the side here, it's like a little bit darker, and because this is so like full coverage and pigmented, it definitely just like conceals everything, and I just really love this lip liner a lot, and I'm definitely looking forward to find more colors from this lip liner range. And moving on to the next lip product is the Bell Hypoallergenic Powder Lipstick. So this lipstick right here, it's very unique in my opinion because it, first of all, it comes in like a pencil type of form, and it just glides on so smoothly onto the lips, and it almost feels like you're using crayon to just like draw onto your lips, and it just glides on so smoothly, and it gives like a powdery matte finish without leaving the lips too dry. So it's pigmented, it's creamy, it glides on smoothly, and yes, the color is super pretty. The lip product definitely deserves a thumbs up from me. And the last product I want to share to you is this right here. This is the Bell Hypoallergenic Waterproof Matte Eyeshadow. As you can see right here, it comes like a creamy matte eyeshadow, which is very weird. It's not like a powder and it's not like a direct cream. It's definitely like more in between. It feels a little bit like mousse, but it's not as light and airy like mousse. So it's a very interesting texture right here, and I tried using it to apply with my fingers, and it just like feels very patchy, especially on the eyelids. I just really don't like it applying with the fingers, so I just use like a very small dense eyeshadow, like dense brush, like eyeshadow dense kabuki brush right here, and just dab a little bit, and a little bit really goes a long way. So I dab a little bit onto the product and just blend it out onto my eyelids, and this thing right here is super pigmented, and you don't even need to like set it with powder, and it just gives a very like smooth effect onto the eyelids, which I really like before using my eyeshadows. That's it for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed this glowy makeup look as much as I did testing these products out. And I do definitely recommend you checking out this Bell Hypoallergenic brand right here, especially if you have sensitive skin. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to watch more of my upcoming videos, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!